you've always been.
Something about being, you know, a free person.
Well, I didn't know you were so busy.
I am. But not recently.
Okay. Yeah, because that's the main one, right?
June.
That's the end.
The only one I got was the end of the 30th and...
Well...
So June 2nd.
Yes, that's correct.
Oh, so it would be the end of May.
It's the one we're talking about.
That's not...
No, we're not closing it.
But if the issue is now we need a replacement.
Well, we can't do it to the company, but we don't have a replacement.
Well, unfortunately, here's the problem. I've already contacted the Attorney General's office. And anybody who acts in an elected office without qualification will be facing potential criminal charges. So, whether he resigns or not.
Oh, we jumped in the gun here.
Yeah, I mean,
someone could just find this out. Yes. I don't know anything about this, but can we...
And how do, I think you need to...
Well, I'll make a motion that we get the budget committee vote to declare the position vacant.
But I need to think that. Can I just say something? I'm going to understand the motion of abstain because I don't think this is the thing to do.
This is great.
Can I
ask then that the vice chair contact Alan and ask him what is going on and determine his status, whether or not, if he does in fact live out of town, which I guess he does, but, and ask for his resignation. He can no longer be part of the committee, as I understand it. But let's just move on from there and see where what he says and what happens.
I agree, having clarified the situation.
But she realized it.
I don't even know why
Address and get done before the next meeting. So That's the department head. But the schedule's all here, so I think that is, that what you're concerned, that we make sure we get to keep that schedule?
Well, I'm going to presume that Michelle will handle the email though. I don't know when the 20th October meeting?
The 25th.
Okay, so Michelle will handle the department email. You'll handle this on the budget. So I'm just saying, she's going to have to own this, because we won't have a chair.
Well, it's a big box.
We've got a nice chair, she takes it, it's not terrible.
And I was wondering.
So we go to our phone box. We'll remind her, say if you can, so we can remind her. So we can go to the phone on the issue.
We have a form, we have 12 people, form is nine.
In the deal on the house.
Seven. One. My house is good.
But our coverage will be with you, Chuck, it's not in your decision. You should be able to get someone on board by then.
One or two people. That's going to stop.
Sorry, I just,
No, that's okay.
So the next issue on the agenda was to do the minutes for the April 26th.
I have a couple corrections to make. There's a spelling error in 2E. Calking is spelled C-A-U-L-K-A-N, different spelling error. But beyond that, in 2C, it should state that the school does not plan to withdraw any funds from the special education fund. And does plan to continue to put money into the building.
Can I get that? Get the notation?
Can you get my notation?
Yeah.
No, so I will send them to you if that's easier for you. I started taking notes in the back. All right, so anyway, so I can send that to you. And the other one is in 2F. That I then illustrated that I was asking the budget committee to see if they would support a one step increase to the teachers who aren't on step. It wasn't my wish. I was just asking if there was going to be support.
We don't recall that as a step. We call that as a step.
No, those are my corrections, and I'll send those off to Corey.
Corey, my name is Corey. One L. And I would say the cell phone would be present. Anybody else?
So I'm sending them. That one was a little, kind of asked me kind of what you think. Sure, we're all on the call.
That's okay.
Yeah.
Motion to accept the minutes of that meeting as amended.
Second.
Call the vote. All in favor?
Aye.
Opposed? Second quarter town water and sewer district committee. Can I get this town?
I don't have copies of everything, but the last time the executive summary going around first. The operating budget is going around next. And the capital items. And then revenue.
I don't know if they should be teaching all the time, you know, whatever we teach. If we can be real.
So like the home storage is just happening?
Yeah.
All right, so from a high level point of view of the budget, from an expense point of view, is something defined. We did have to make some budget changes that are noted on the documentation, where we had to increase budgets from highway department and move most of the contingency in order to do that. And we budgeted some of the highway department lines to help cover those interstate shortages. Most of them are due to the budget that we had, and the additional expense associated with that, providing some access to the equipment that causes the equipment and the vehicle maintenance. And also the backhoe is expensive. So that's the highway department, so we do budget that. Town hall maintenance, we have the extraordinary expenses there, so we had to re-budget that. We moved budget dollars from several lines in order to do it. And extraordinary expenses there were two circulator pumps, which we talked about before. We actually did the renovation and repairs for the special system, repairs for the HVAC system, and some other sorts of things. So we've got sufficient budget dollars now to do the mold remediation that we still need to do this year, and then hopefully cover. The other things I wanted to point out to you is that as we did last year, so there's now a column for the original budget, and to the right, calling out the revised budget. So just to tell you what the board thinks that those budgets, how we budgeted right now, they're going to start the budget process next year.
Sorry.
When we start the budget process next year, we start with the original budget. So the revised budget is different. It's just to help us operate for the minute, you know, as we go along the year. The other thing to note in the report is the down below at the bottom, you've got the expenses that are charged for 2016 purchase orders. So they were engineering costs for the town hall drainage and the roofing of the season. And you can see those in the 54 to reference to that ferry board in the town report. Now, when I wrote this, I said, except for the highway department, town hall maintenance, you don't anticipate for this expense budget issue, but I came out with nothing still. Since then, one of the accidents that happened to one of our snow plows was we thought Primex was going to send Primex is our insurance manager. We thought they were going to send a check directly to the auto repair shoulders. And it didn't happen, so now we have to pay the $4,000. We will have a revenue, but still an expense. So that's what Jeff's estimating. There's a snow plow repair to plow itself that needs to be done. So this just happened over the last day. So I think the board's going to look at the purchase order that we have signed but have not executed yet on good maintenance and see if we can make some adjustments to that.
Do I understand correctly? I don't know if it's a rumor or a misheard it, that when people get our vehicles, we pay for the deductible?
It is often, no, it's usually we fund it to us, but we have to, it takes a while for that to process.
Okay, so we're out nothing.
We will be out nothing, but on the rev net, from the net point of view, but of course the expense is
good. I'm sorry,
well, the expense is coming in against the appropriate expenditure. But yes, net, we should be fine. In other words,
we're not going to pay the deductible then.
I can check on that. It takes a while. We have paid the deductible in one of these. It takes a while for the insurance company to ascertain whatever field it needs to ascertain to refund us the deductible.
So we want the deductible up front, then we determine if this other driver is
yeah. 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 And that's how it's happening with the town.
Mm-hmm. But in the event the other driver doesn't have insurance, then you must pay it.
Then it comes in collision with the actual.
Then you have to pay it because the insurance
is for the insurance.
So, I want to make sure that the last statement is. So, we have some money within the highway department. In other words, it's pretty important to have any activities yet. So, we think, well, I'm going to recommend the board go back, either reduce it or eliminate it entirely, so that we know that we don't have any difficulties with any other things that might transpire in the department. So, that's the big picture on the expense line, the revenue line. We see those proceeds from the two bonds from the municipal bond bank, the fire station and the transfer station, and the short-term construction loans we paid by the state and the folks and affairs, and they all reside the new accounts that we created in the financial public department. We are awaiting reports from the first home of the new farm Camp Wally. We anticipate a possible revenue shortfall. We were hoping that they could be neutral.
Well, for the town, the list is still as much revenue as we had budgeted on the expense side, but they're still working to try to obtain some donations. A special note, motor vehicle permits are up and the hydro revenue is up. I anticipate that the motor vehicles will continue to be up at the end of the year. I'm not sure about hydro. We'll have to see what the remaining quarter show. We're receiving additional dollars from the state for road work. We're having a public hearing on Monday. The next step the town has to do is accept the additional dollars. And that's the next step. What we did find out is that they are non-lapping, so we thought we were going to have to spend this year, but they're going to be in some kind of non-lapping account. The details of this are still being worked out by the DRA. So it's close to $50,000, just $49,000 something additional block grant money from the state.
Are you saying the state is holding the non-lapsing account, or they're going to give
it to
us and we
want
it?
Yeah.
So it's going to go into trust account then, doesn't it?
It will be in something that will be non-lapsing. So we're still working, we're still figuring out the details with the DRA about what it actually goes into. $49,000
plus something. Here, I'll do it for the touch and
round up. So, I think that's
the interest that I can't do.
That's it for the big picture.
Go ahead. When do we start actually spending dollars from the budget that is going on?
So,
when we go to town meeting and the budget is approved in March,
yes.
When are those dollars actually available?
January 1st.
Okay. So, we spend before it's approved by the town.
Well, what the guidance is that you spend in sort of like the way you have been spending
right.
in the prior year. So if the budget had been set up in the prior year. So it would not be wise to introduce a new purpose, for example, that let's say, like dental benefits. Okay, we wouldn't want to start dental benefits for which we had no budget line set up, you know, it hadn't been in the budget something we wanted to do. But otherwise, we pretty much are, you know, we spend where we had spent the prior year.
In the same manner, yeah.
Yeah, I think it's mostly your salaries in emergencies and in which your any benefit that goes with the salary is where most of your hits are. I mean, they came in and said they wanted to put a $4,000
addition on to something, you wouldn't do that until after your budget was approved, because that's not standard. I mean.
Yeah, I mean, I would say that that's true. We tend to, if there's some new capital expense that we're hoping to come to the town for, even if it's in the operating budget, you know, a small capital expense, we wouldn't do it until. So it's you know, it's our regular operating sorts of things. Nothing's happened though, so you know, anything, you know, some maintenance in town hall or whatever, but that's, it is FY17 funds that we're spending in FY17. Does that help?
Mm-hmm. What would you like to go over first? Are people interested in line by line? Are they interested in just the highlights?
I could take that page.
So page one. Are there any comments?
I do. Printing and copying, do you expect to do any more? But I know that every select board meeting, you say, well, we have to put it up, we have to put it up because there's no money. So,
there's a problem, I'm sorry.
The printing and copying.
What printing and copying are you putting on?
You're tabling it.
Oh, the new equipment. Possible new equipment.
Oh, okay.
That's printing and copying, you know, sort of paper and toners. And
so, do you think that the 319 is going to do you for the rest of the 6 months?
Well, the truth, I probably don't know the answer to that, but I'm not concerned. I think
okay.
That's the best way to. That's not a line that I'm concerned about yet.
All right.
Anybody
else?
Yeah, contingency.
Uh-oh.
I'm sorry. You're right.
It's 233.
Go ahead, Kyle.
We only have $291. What happens? Where are we going to get money if we need it now?
Well, Charlie, I mean, contingency is there for unusual things that happen. So
I know
unusual things that happen, and we've moved it. And so, you know, we'll manage, you know, the way we always manage if something else transpires. You know, I don't have a...
No, I know that. I'm just curious if you know.
Finding what? I'm not expecting anything except the highway department, and I think that we can manage it within the highway department budgetary items. So we're not anticipating anything. This is, you know, not seeing anything on the horizon.
Okay.
Well, I'm sorry.
Well, you know, I think the contingency fund is essentially a rainy day fund. Is that right? I mean, that's how it's been treated.
It's there for unusual expenses.
What?
Yeah.
Rainy day.
Yeah. However you describe it.
And the piggy bank is damn near empty. So should anything else come up, you're going to have to do a lot of shuffling around, right?
Absolutely.
Okay.
Safe to say, though, the total budget is at 43.7%. So, therefore, we're under our 50%. If we have to move money from one line to another, if we call it contingency, we call it something else, we move the money. I think the overall, I think what we should do is be looking at the bigger picture of the overall 43.7% as we're in good shape.
Well,
might be sense.
Aaron?
Unfortunately, some of these other items, that would beg the question, we've got 7% to play around with, right? Because we're at 50% of the year and we're at 43% expended, right?
Okay.
Okay. That's not actually how it is because a lot of these things are committed. I mean, this doesn't show like the school does where they're obligated in the future. So, there's a lot thinner margin there than one might suspect.
Well, that works both ways, though, Vern, because there's some of these lines that are 100% expensive because they're just one-time invoices and we pay them off. So, although I agree with Bill, I'm not worried. The board is currently not worried. We're looking at things. The highway department is probably the one area that we're going to have to work on, but we've got the ability within the highway department to manage that. So, from a big picture point of view, I think we're doing okay. That's all I can say. Yeah.
And again, to that same point, I think the big picture is the one we need to look at. And you know, a budget is only a guess at what we think our expenditures are going to be, and if we have to move money to do things, we do. But I think overall, 43.7% is good, and Suzanne tells us everything looks good. I think that's as good as we're going to get. I mean, to say, well, you know, we spent $5 more here out of a, what do we have, $1 million, you know, whatever the budget is. I think we're in good shape then. Thank you.
Any other comments on page 2?
Yes, I got one on number 36, town clerk. I was looking at the schedule here. I don't see the town clerk scheduled to come see us on any of our meetings. Why?
Because the department has.
No,
the town clerk doesn't work for me.
Everybody else brings their budget.
Town clerk doesn't work for me, so somebody else can answer that question.
She's an elected official. I don't think the town clerk has ever come to a budget meeting, in my recollection.
Well, and she's supposed to present her own budget if she chooses to. I think that's what his point is. Mm-hmm. She's an elected official who doesn't report to anybody but the residents in the town. Is how it's been determined. So she has the right to present her own budget if she chooses to. She hasn't chose to. So.
Yeah, it's the same as the fire chief.
He's
an elected
position.
No,
he works for the sports
board.
No,
well, he's elected, but he has submitted budgets to the sports board.
The town clerk submits her budgets to us, and we incorporate them into the budget.
So if she doesn't like what they decide to do with it, she can come in and present herself.
Does that satisfy you?
I just want to know why we can't ask her a question. Like we do the library and everybody else. That's all.
I mean, we can invite her. I don't know, aside from that. She presents a budget to you.
Yes, we have, yes.
And then?
So we incorporate it.
Right. I mean,
it's just a thought.
Yeah, I mean, it really doesn't matter to me either way. I know I've never seen it, not to say that it can't happen or shouldn't happen, but if she's not, if she's okay with whatever her budget is, we could invite her.
Well, I know we invite her.
Do you want me to do that?
Fall from the side of safety. I mean, if she's upset about something or wants to advocate for something, let's invite her.
That being said, we would need a suggestion on when I would be inviting her.
That's okay.
I think it would be to do it when you're the town. Send out the invite, drop it at the front.
Right, but I'm just trying to see
what
state.
It looks like, yeah, the highway, town, and CIP is on the 27th. Read that right?
Mm-hmm.
27th of December.
There may be some changes to the draft. She is the last thing on the agenda. There may be some changes. Just let me know.
Well,
could we perhaps then postpone this until we talk about schedule changes later on in the meeting?
Or would it be more appropriate just to ask her to come whenever the town is doing their budget, because that's what it's associated with? So we invite her to come along with the when the town. If you or Mike or whoever does it for the select board.
Sounds good to me.
I didn't think
so.
Budget's my favorite.
Okay.
Okay. No, okay.
When Suzanne presents her budget, not the town's budget, but her budget.
It's not my budget. It's just my favorite.
So if that's acceptable, then.
Yeah.
Anything else on page 2? Moving on to page 3. I had a question about, you said Camp Raleigh.
What's the row number? I think I figured out the rows now, so I can be able to talk to you.
Very helpful that way.
Oh, no, I'm sorry. I'm looking at background check. I'll wait until we get to Camp Raleigh itself, yeah. But that's okay. I don't have a question about that.
Yeah, that's background check. Okay, bye.
Well, I'll just say that the reason that we've expended more is because of Camp Raleigh staff. So we are really trying to abide by our, you know, the advice that we've been given that people who work in the town need to have a background check, whether they're getting a transfer station folks or they're working as counselors, you know, some of them with our children, especially with our children. So that's you know, we'll have to think about that for next year and maybe beef that line up a little bit more because the counselors will, you know, there's probably a big turnover and so we may have a number each year that will need a background check.
Anybody else on page three? Page four.
Yeah, line 115. Did the lieutenant get a road report?
That's page five.
Oh.
I told you you needed the right page.
I flipped two pages, I'm sorry.
Does anybody have anything on four? Okay, Charlie, go ahead on line 115.
Okay, I got a question on line 115. I thought a week or two after the town meeting, the select board gave the lieutenant a raise.
Yes,
is this true?
Yes. 5,000. Close to that.
I thought it was 2,000 something.
Pardon?
2,000 something.
I think it was 5,000.
Okay. Can you explain why?
You get the recommendation of the chief. You know, some of these personnel items, you know, I'm not going to get into the whatever, but with the recommendation of the chief, the board met with both Chief Ducharme and the lieutenant, and based on the conversation and the workload and you know, the surrounding context, we decided to give them a $5,000 raise.
Okay.
Which we are allowed to do.
Oh, no.
So.
Okay, so maybe the revised budget probably should show that?
It probably should, yeah. At the time,
Chief
Ducharme said it was coming from his budget, so we can ask him where and actually what. That's a good point.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
Can I ask on 118? So 5,000 was moved to the town hall maintenance. Is there a reason? Like, how did the chief get that out of that salary? Is that not filled right now, or is it?
The officer that we hired is starting August.
The academy.
So we hired him, but we delayed his start, I think, because of when the next academy was not going to be there, so that's why there's money in that line. He was currently spending, but we're not anticipating that he's going to spend the whole, if it was $5,000.
Okay. Anybody else? Page six.
Their printer, some of their office equipment, not police equipment necessarily, you know, like printers, paper.
Just because if they, because they're like almost out.
Chief Ducharme, he's a really good. I mean, both Chief Ducharme and Chief Rutherford are on top of their budget. You really don't worry about them. They don't worry about Jeff either. I mean, Caroline, except that he has a lot of things that happen in the highway department. And so, but Caroline manages that pretty carefully. So, so to the extent that, you know, there are these kinds of things, we really don't have to take them. So, I don't think, that's how I would sleep over. Ross, I think I would sleep over about that.
But I also think that he stops up whenever Staples has a sale.
That is true. A good point. I just hope that something broke that will.
I don't think anything broke, but they're in the process of doing some equipment upgrades, and some of them may be perceived as office equipment. I don't know that. You know, they're getting some radios. I know some more police, but anyway. I don't remember an event happening that seems unusual. So I can see what you're seeing, but again, I'm not worried.
Mm-hmm. Anybody else on page 6? Page 7?
Page 150. Where are we getting our fuel now? For the vehicles?
No. Okay, you're on page 6.
Page 7. 150. Okay. Vehicle fuel,
150. Oh.
I think we have a couple of arrangements, one with Irving.
Okay, yes.
And we might still have one with Mr. Mike, and I think they kind of use some depending on pricing. So far, the state is still proving to be more expensive. So we're continuing to do it that way.
They're doing a very good job on that.
Pardon?
They're doing a very good job on that.
They are.
Anybody else? Okay. No comment? Page 9. Charlie?
214, salt. And we're going to cut down on salt this year or what? As we seem to.
Well, you can indicate if you'd like to.
Well.
Yes. The state recommends salt. You know, the sand is not good from a stormwater management point of view, and neither one is great environmentally. They both have bad things about it, but the state recommends salt, and they did that a couple of years ago, so, you know, we've got the calibration piece, instrument, or whatever, on the salt machine, and
spreaders.
Thank you so much. Thank you. It's not just math that I challenge.
The thing on the back of it.
Also work. So, you know, so we're trying to, you know, be careful as possible. It was a bad winter from an icing point of view. So it wasn't so much the snowstorms. I mean, we had snowstorms too that came later. But at the beginning of the winter, when it didn't seem so bad, there was a lot of icing nonetheless in the morning. So he gets called out. He's called in. So, you know, this is sometime over the next 4 to 6 weeks, I think he'll get the state bid for salt, and we'll try to figure out what it is. So we think we've been conservative, and by that I mean we think we've budgeted sufficient, right?
You never know.
You never know, but we think we're hoping this is sufficient to get us through the rest of the year.
Okay.
So we're, you know, fingers crossed for a, you know, mild and long fall.
Or at least if we did that weather, no ice.
No ice. So he hasn't done the mowing yet. There's that roadside mowing yet. Correct. Okay. Yeah. We do have a purchase order out for that. It's a company in Vermont. We have to find a different vendor for that. But we do have a purchase order for it. Catch basic thing is what's going on this week. Possibly done or almost done.
Anybody else? Page 10.
I have a question on the uniforms and cleaning.
The 227?
227. So are we still anticipating budgeting, I know it's long range thinking, the same amount for next year for uniforms where it's not being used this year?
It is being used. I think it didn't start early enough, but it maybe didn't start in January.
Okay.
So obviously we'll look at that. You know, right? If we've got a contract, if we're using the same vendor and it gives us bid or contract for the following year, we'll budget what that says. This was our first year with it, so we weren't sure, I think, who the vendor was going to be.
Anything else? Page 11.
He is reasonable, though. So, hopefully maybe that's a place where we can
We're not sure about the summer camp.
That could be one possibility. But, you know, things are looking reasonably well.
Does anybody have any comments? Yep, Charlie?
I got a question on line 20, command vehicle. What's the status on that?
That's not revenue, I don't think, if I don't have it.
Oh, it's over on that page.
No, we're on revenue.
Revenue.
Sorry. We're on the...
Any other comments from anybody?
Just a general comment, not sure about the budget, it's about the reassessment. So obviously values have gone up significantly.
About 20% overall on average.
20%.
That's the mathematical average.
So when would you anticipate an adjustment in the tax rate? Because
when the tax rate set, so in the fall.
Okay. So this coming fall.
Yes. So during this period, residents, property owners, I guess, will have the chance to come talk to Avatar if there's an issue or one of the things we were surprised. They were prognosticating at first, you know, maybe a 10-12% increase in the overall valuation. So it came back 20%. Keith Chad from Avatar did say early on too that land was being assessed at a higher, the land appraisals were going, the values were going up, and so I guess that I'm guessing that the increase even above what he was talking about, a lot of it has to come with land just based on some of the people that I heard from. So what will happen, Kim, is once any adjustments are made during this process with Avatar, we'll just get the best value as currently stands. It has to be set hopefully sometime in September, so that the sooner we can get this started, it's really important this year where you've got this big change to let people know as soon as possible how the combination of tax rate and best value is going to So we're hope. So a lot of things have to get reported to the DRA in the September, early October timeframe. So we're going to try to get all of those in place so that we can have the tax rate set by the DRA. Now, when we were working on the budget last year, the budget we're currently in, you know, the board was hoping to have a tax burden this year that is roughly the same as it was last year. So if the tax burden is the same, and if your tax bill is up, then you can infer that your valuation went up at a greater, with a greater increase than the 20%. If your tax bill is down, then your valuation was less than 20% increase. So, but that's only if we manage to keep the tax burden the same, and we won't know that until to it, but it will have an impact on them. We understand that the sooner we can get this out to folks, the better. Did that help?
We did, yeah. There's just been a lot of discussion around concern about the potential increase based on the new assessment and what they probably don't understand. Well, what they will understand is this year they'll see it. It's like a scale. You know,
our tax rate will go down. It's guaranteed the tax rate is going down. That doesn't mean, though, that your tax bill is going down, or my tax bill is going down. Can they go up? Can they go down? If you take a look at your new total, the new Avatar total, and what it was before, and I think they said both in their letter. Doesn't the letter have your old one or whatever? If you just get the percentage increase, if it's more than 20%, then your value has increased more than the average. Less than a 20% increase, then your overall property value has decreased relative to the average in the town. And your tax bill will probably show a decrease.
Yeah, I just wondered if it would have been helpful for residents to kind of understand the process a little bit, because there's a lot of concern, a lot of discussion around town about this potential increase. But what they don't understand is the process and that they should do a reduction in the tax rate. So, you know, unfortunately, you hear more and more people saying, yeah, I'm leaving, I can't afford to live here anymore. So, you know, maybe it's important to convey it in the next newsletter that they make, we'll see an adjustment in the tax rate.
The letter did say don't multiply this by your last year's tax rate, but, you know, I can understand. I mean, it's just it's a common way to try to figure it out. And nonetheless, there are some people who I have been stunned at some of the increases that I have seen that people have shown me. And a lot of it appears to be land related, not solely, but mostly land related. So, I mean, there are going to be some difficult things. Where I'm talking to Chad later on this week about Woods Run, which I think is a whole, or is that the name of the development of the road, but, you know, that area, River Road and Woods Run, where they had some pretty significant increases at one point, you know, 50%, you know, 40%. I mean, that's a lot. Now, if that's the case, then there are people in the town, you know, in order to get that average, there are people in the town who are on the other end of that. I'm not, but, you know.
I'm not.
So, so we may see, I'll talk to Jeff. If it looks like it's helpful, we may do a, you know, maybe a Woods Run information session, because they seem particularly upset. Well, they're heavily, there have been some significant changes, and, you know, it stands to reason. Or we could just, you know, maybe just have maybe broaden it to be just more of an information session.
That would be very helpful. You know, send out an email to, I don't want to call it public hearing, but the public discussion.
The public information session. Yeah. I mean, it's a really good idea. You know, it's complicated. You know, I've got a better handle on it than I did when I first started. But, you know, it's the relationship between all of these things can be complicated. And so. That's a good idea. Thank you.
I'll start with revenue. We need to capital items. That's where you are, Charlie.
Yep, just a second. The command vehicle, what's the status on that?
Chief Burford is not brought up to PO yet. He has done some research and has gone out looking at quotes, getting quotes and stuff. And that's about, I was expecting something sooner because he didn't come talk to us.
Because I thought he said he'd be under budget.
Or just about at budget.
Yeah, that was just about at budget.
Yeah.
Now the follow-up is on the highway truck. A highway truck is for $20,000, but Jeff can't get one for $20,000 equipped, right?
Well, I don't know the answer to that. And trying to think of what, I mean, I can give you my own opinion. It's not the board opinion.
No. Mm-hmm.
I'm not hot to trot on this. I think that there's sufficient, you know, just based on the conversation at the town meeting, you know, there's sufficient ambivalence or disagreement about the purpose. I mean, when the board brought it forward, we wanted, you know, just, you know, get a used, I don't, you know, just get a used truck, whatever, just to relieve the burden on, you know, larger equipment. But the truth of the matter is that because of the state contract with vehicles, a used truck can end up costing more than a new truck that on the state contract. But nonetheless, there would be no appetite for this board member to entertain going into the operating budget for any potential overage to that
okay.
contract. That's my, you know, where I stand. That's where I stand.
Okay. Thank you.
Well, I have a question about, well, both the command vehicle and the highway department service truck, and that is, I thought these were coming off the state bid contract, so it's like a fixed price.
Yes.
And so why is the fire chief going around getting quotes when the state's already established this is the price?
Oh, you know, that's a good question. Maybe the command vehicle is not one of the state contracted vehicles.
I thought you said it was.
But it was the same thing.
The highway department was. It's a good question. I'll ask them.
Actually, a related question is, we have some of those Ford Explorer SUVs that are leaking carbon monoxide down in Massachusetts that we had ours checked if they're the same type of vehicle. The SUVs, Ford SUVs, that we have for police cars. There's a problem with them when they put the quote interceptor package in for some reason, and policemen are like passing out from CO2 points, carbon monoxide poisoning. Have we checked our vehicles to see if they're got a carbon monoxide problem? I'm sure that if the chief thought in a moment he was driving around in a poisoned vehicle, he'd let us know. But
it's fairly new on the news, too, so.
Yeah, I just heard it tonight.
Thank you.
I have a portable carbon monoxide detector if you'd like to borrow it. Or if they would like, no, I'm serious. That's what we've been doing in Massachusetts. They've been putting in these.
I'll let him know.
I've only heard that anecdotally. I have not heard any definitive department say this is bad.
A police officer ran into the back of somebody's car because he was gone unconscious.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Well, I didn't know that. I heard that they weren't looking into carbon monoxide making in the Ford Explorers. Thank you.
Well, that was the city of Austin, Texas, but this was in Massachusetts. Mm-hmm. So, getting closer to home.
Any other questions or comments on the capital item stuff?
Just real quick, can you give us a rundown on the transfer station and what's going on and where we are?
On all of the bond warrant projects, maybe? Rundown on all of those? Is that people would like to know what's going on there? I'd be happy to. So the transfer station went well within budget. The repaving had. Not just repainting, we're regrading in order to get sheeting action on the pavement, and so there's swales and ditching and whatnot, so that there's proper runoff and everything. The retaining wall was fixed. You can't see it because it's behind the recycle thing. They've made improvements to the visual aspect of it. It doesn't show. We thought that because of the grading and the that the height was going to change. Such that people wouldn't need a railing at the top of it, but it didn't turn out that way. So we are in the process of getting a railing. It should be up very soon. The compactor is the concrete pads were put in sometime within the past week as pure. I think the compactor is now in place on the pad, and we're waiting for the hookup to happen. I'm really excited about that. I want to see what reduction in hauling costs we're going to enjoy from that, because we now will no longer be sending hauling compactors that are 2/3 full. They will always be full. The new compactor is 5 yards more than the other ones. It's a bigger one because they're all bigger ones. So it'll be a bigger load. So we'll see. We'll see what the or savings that we can enjoy from that. So that's any questions on the transfer station?
No, it's very nice.
Good, thank you. Appreciate it.
What are our paving costs for that?
I'm sorry?
The paving costs?
The whole budget was $190,000. I don't know that I know the detail of just that it was paving and grading. And the retaining wall, so I don't have the.
You don't have the breakdown of that?
No, not in front of me.
Could we get that from the next week?
When we have it all, when we have all the costs.
Well, you have a bid package, right?
There were several. So there was the pipe, which did the paving, regrading, and retaining wall, and some of the other stuff. Then we had concrete pads with someone else, and
for the candidate recycling for the equipment. Fire
engine? No, I just wanted to know, are we still using the same hall? Have we changed?
Are you talking about the...
The pest control thing to get the dumpster.
The municipal solid waste or the recycling?
Recycling, no, the solid waste.
Oh, that's a sad tale.
That is.
Sad tale. I mean, if you want me to...
No, I just... So we had one and then we got another one.
No, it's not that. Can I run? People, so our municipal solid waste goes to waste management. That's as part of the Lamprey Regional Waste Cooperative that we belong to. And that's a 10-year contract. We started it last year. So we're enjoying some lesser costs. Mm-hmm. In part of this new contract. So we've seen that in the budget last year. We talked about it. The hauling of municipal solid waste happens through a subset of the Lamprey Regional Cooperative. So I think there are five towns. They got together, but then this is before my time, but I think I understand. So they got together and decided to form a little trucking consortium. Mm-hmm. So that group of five towns bought a truck. That group of five towns hired a truck driver, and through the board, and we're Jody Services are reference to this. That truck driver has been problematic for some towns. People are not happy dealing with them.
Mm-hmm.
We tried to get out. We explored removing ourselves from the trucking consortium last year. Norfolk was thinking of doing the same, but the trust wasn't fully paid yet. It was going to cost us a lot of money, so we all stayed in. We've asked Jody to go back and take a look at this again, because I think it was not the best decision for the school group to hire a truck and a truck driver, because you lose the nimbleness and agility to respond to different things. You're stuck now with this fraud and things. So we do think we could do better if we're out in the open market every time looking for people to haul on municipal solid waste and waste management. That's the contract, the language of the contract, we bring ourselves to that. How we get it there can be, we can do it ourselves, but we're sort of stuck here.
Yeah.
A little bit. Mm-hmm. So we're looking at it. That's an interesting question. So that's the transfer station. The fire engine is ordered. It seems to be moving ahead on the assembly line or however it's happening, and we're expecting it to find its destination in December. We've got the Garrett ramp for almost $10,000 that will offset this once we destroy the fire engine with this replacement. So we have some hoopah around that when it comes to but there are no issues that I've been ready to go, so I think we can move along to fine. Public project should be starting hopefully, maybe the next Thursday, Friday, maybe this point off next week. We put out a bid, we hired Parker and Daughters, Pittsfield, New Hampshire. They are starting on Willie Street and going into the lower mill to either drain pipe and then to the pipe. Now, I kept John informed of the schedule.
I would suggest that you work with him. That's sure. HCA is an
answer. Jeff is our sort of field representative.
They're not for the sleep.
So water is implicated on Willie Street. Water and soil.
That now on the first campus. There's some still on the
I'll make sure to Jeff, so we have, let John know.
That's, yeah.
60.
Yeah.
So one issue about the corporate tax is the low mill.
Oh.
There's an underground tank. And it's called a UPA off. No, AU off, accessible use restriction area. And it abuts the our right of way. And the likelihood that there's been infiltration from that area to the important sector or drain pipe is, you know, I don't want to say small, but we're not anticipating it. But, you know, but. So that's the one sort of
it's an old abandoned house or something?
It's an abandoned tank. I don't know what it's called. And it was a very, you know, Foyle Tanners was the engineering company that responded to this, that created this AUR, you know, very responsible. I'm quite sure that they would have conservatively, you know, marked out something that more than covered the possible infiltration area. So we've got, so our engineers are anticipating finding anything in our trench that we make, but, in which case everything stops and it's a lot of places.
I was just going to say, we've got the things to help us,
it's the same contract.
Yes, but that could be a big problem.
We have to contingency, we do have to contingency funds, but we just, and there's also the question that what is responsible. The tank is not on our property. The tank is the question. That's why there's a pavilion for having to the tank. We don't own the land where the tank is. We have to bury the tank.
Right? So one on the sewer is what is it?
Pardon?
The water and sewer is not on the three quarters of the project on it. But they reach it not to that
place. Oh, well, maybe it's me. So if you're standing at the building out of Santa Falls River, the tank is to the water to dry. I don't know. I just don't know.
I don't know if it's holding back a billion years ago. When
I think the engineers might know. I just don't think that I necessarily know the numbers.
This is why you don't have to talk about it. You have to understand. Mm-hmm. So, you know, you have to go take a lot of
just remember, though, that it butts the front right way. It's close to the real building. So maybe it's not.
Maybe
it's not. Well, it's not in our right way. Right to the right of our right, the plus our right. But the tank doesn't abut it, it's this area that we have.
Yeah.
You
know.
But, the contractor, everybody's all set. We don't seem to have any issues there. We're waiting for final permit from the Utah Army Corps of Engineers that pine tree that came through. So,
so that's that to take the tank. And what they look for.
They have to tell us the week before they're going to open it up. They have to have an environmental engineer on board. This is all part of the bid requirement. Mm-hmm. We'll probably have Boyle Tanner there that day too. And to test, just so, you know, to test to make sure that there's no infiltration. But if there is, we have to stop. So we have to figure out how do we do it. Keep it out, close it, take it out, and close it, and back to that. The rest of it is straightforward. I mean, the culprit's closing, you know,
the public, but, you know, they're public.
Extending each one, each of the two, find a way of being extended in the front topography adjustments that are being made, so that the same money, the erosion doesn't So, but everything is absolutely in budget right now, so the question is going to be
for October, could you get me a list of the police cruisers, the highway vehicles, and the fire department? What vehicles they own?
Yep.
I didn't see it in the top book. I looked.
That's it.
I haven't missed it, but I don't
know. No, it's not just your mind. I just think it's kind of a mess.
Okay. Thank you very much.
Any questions on water? No complaints?
Sorry. So can you say the well is done, so it's up and running then?
Yes.
Okay.
Yes,
for
the general solid water. Yeah. We've got 90,000 to 100,000 gallons. And we run water once a week on 2 days. They got both south signs up and then it's following the notice. And we have a new website up and running on wellingtonwateringschool.org, which is in that. Sewer is at 50.4%. So any questions on sewer? Oh, let me get back to water. We had a leak test going on. Company came in for nothing, and they couldn't find any major leaks in town. But he was only on it for a day and a half, so I'm not sure. Really. He said he went to the summit areas and couldn't find anything major. I'll leave it there. They come through and they go through the whole town, and they, if there's any major leaks, they'll find them.
So this is just a regular testing warning.
No, they
wouldn't. If you have a leak in there, what do you
call it? Well, wrong for leaks. Yeah, they couldn't reach the ground. We had one there last year at the cemetery for the whole season. You know, we found it. Sometimes you can't detect. So they don't detect. They do sometimes have a sound system.
A water leak, a sewer leak, or both?
Water.
I wasn't sure. Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
And then that's if you said the water, I mean, general fund and well is up and running, but water.
Water we run once.
But that electric bill is.
That's because we have, things. In the running, whatever that well runs, that's why we don't run it alone. We're at the point now where I think we can get a halt of that thing because we haven't been checking. We've been testing it, you know, but we never know when it's coming back.
But, so is it right that General Sullivan's well electric is roughly 400 a month to run all the time, and the other one once a week is 1400? Does that sound right?
Yeah.
204?
Yeah.
There's a lot more treatment going on.
Oh, yeah, there's more treatment and more because it's a deep well and it keeps a lot of bedrock there. Okay. We're not dealing with us like South Carolina. I don't know if they're going to be paid now. And they haven't even treated it yet. They're going to ask. No, we're good. We're very good.
I've got a question on the Blowin building. They're looking at putting in 19 single bedroom apartments. That going to affect your sewer?
No. This is not written down yet. It just came in and presented it to us. But we haven't signed anything on it yet. And then when he was leaving, he mentioned something, well, maybe there might be a couple of bedrooms or apartments down. What's the other? Nothing down to this. So.
Planning board last night, they presented 19.
Yeah. But we haven't signed on.
No.
Yeah, he was having 19 to us, but when he was leaving, he was like, well, I might have a couple of minutes. But he'll have a big entrance. Very good. Water and sewer, he'll have a big entrance. Then he's not allowed to go downstairs.
Thank you.
Never know. And you know that as well as I do. So any questions?
The second, or the third entry for the agenda is the same as the second entry. To the finance and budget workshop by the Municipal Association. I don't know what his intent was except to give the website.
So the, when Bill was here, he had asked the board for some dollars to put in front of it. So it was 10 budget committee members to call this workshop that the Municipal Association provides. And so when I saw it cross my email, I realized it happened to send these people. I'm not sure exactly why, and they haven't told us so far. So I thought I would bring it to the attention of the budget committee. We had budgeted, I think it's 10 people a year. So that's the money that's been available for 10 people on the budget committee. It's a really worthwhile workshop. To go to it, describe, go through the RSA, because here's what a budget committee is supposed to do, and here's what the budget committee is not supposed to do, and, what are some of the, any changes that may have happened, sometimes the legislation will create some single thing, or budgetary, whatever, for us to pay attention to, I'm blanking, but one year, any kind of reserve fund that you can do. So, what was that, like, example of the surcharge on the motor vehicle? Yeah. Thank you. Thank you. So, anyway, it's a worthwhile workshop. If I don't know how the committee would like, if there were the three people, I'm not sure how to manage that, but. And I think there are two locations in September 1.
September 12th is in Bedford, and that's Tuesday, September 12th, and Tuesday, September 26th is at the Advent Grand Summit Hotel in Bartlett. Beautiful view of it.
I'm paying for another accommodation.
I went to it, I thought it was very good. And so I was, for anybody who hasn't been, I think we could. It's a day long thing. I think they give you lunch. They give you some books and documents. And I thought it was a very good topic. So.
Well, I suggest that if you want to think about it, just send a little email to the board if you'd like to try to get some of the free or something else.
Are we all ready to wait now? We'll see how this goes. But the first thing I'll do is answer the questions that were brought up on the April meeting. So we have those. I did not write down who asked the question. I apologize for that. So some of you may have to say if we can do or not. So there was a question on the library services and library original hours. And the answer on that, I explained that the library had now become a unit and therefore more time was required, which was only part of it. That library aid was also picked up as a special education aid. We needed a special education aid for a couple of days a week, and that a person is trained, able to step into that. So at that point, that aid became a full-time aid. But it's all under the one is one person. It's still labeled as a library aid, so that's why that's. Anyway, so that's the answer to that. And if there's further questions on that, I don't know if they apologize. Then there was a question on the school board expenditure, which I had explained that evening, I believe, back in April, had to do with the fact that we had not yet received the matching grant money for a grant that we had applied for and qualified for, and that is indeed the reason that is looks like an overage. It's we will get that money when the match comes in. Custodial, there was a question on the custodial, exploration of additional money. So a couple things happened, and again, I explained in April that we did change the custodial staffing from what was budgeted. We had budgeted for two part-time custodians. Before that could take effect, before even that 2 year was out, one of the custodians left, leaving us the two that were going to go part-time, one of them left, so we decided to keep on one full-time. And then hire hourly as needed to fill in. And that made a difference, of course. That it was full-time, meaning that we had to do retirement, qualify for benefits, all those things. So that did indeed increase the amount of money for that. And the custodian substitute work, which is what was going to be hourly work, had not been budgeted either. So that's done. Now, obviously, in the budget for this year that we're in, the school year starts in September, we have budgeted for those substitute hours. So I think we've budgeted up to 300 hours. Along with that, there was a question on the lawn care. And basically what happened with the lawn care, the line for lawn care essentially is not being spent. The custodian is doing it. So the money that's in the lawn care line, the $3,250 that's in the lawn care line, is essentially it's helping to offset the higher custodial costs. They're actually just doing the work rather than hiring it out. Again, if the person who asked that question wants to ask for more details, please go right ahead. There was something on equipment on the line that had to do with. And this had to do, so we had indeed encumbered some custodial equipment. Part of it was for, it's called custodial equipment, but there was carpeting being installed and some things like that. So some of those things were in that line. Along here. And I think that was it. Do you remember any other questions that you didn't answer? Before we get into the actual budget, I have one thing I would like to bring up. The school board will... Other questions?
This is David and Kurt. Why do we not have June 30th as our date?
We have what the most current, the current budget that has been reviewed by the school board is what you have. So this is what happens this time of year. The school board does not meet in July, so we do not have an updated budget. Well, I didn't. And if we did, it was one the school board had not seen, so it was not an official one. So, I mean, I don't know. Maybe we met in July last year. I can't remember. But we make public things that the school board has seen, and we just don't have it. The latest one
we have. As the treasurer, I know I'm still signing checks based on this budget that you're talking about, so they don't have everything in there yet.
Yeah, I mean, in terms of actually closing the school year, after closing the budget year, that won't happen until September is when Marie aims for. Sometimes it doesn't happen until October, but we don't close the budget until September.
I remember last year having this discussion. Yes, we understand you close in September, that's your part of the tunnel, but you give us a new as of. And it's either you or Alan that says, sure.
No, it's not me.
I'll look at that.
Yeah, I mean it's possible that you got one. I don't know. This is what the school district has. And this is the last budget the school board has seen. So what I want is, yes,
you have copies of the upcoming computer.
Oh, Dennis took the one copy I have. I have one extra comment. I'm going to get bounced back.
No.
So before we get into the action. Before we get into the actual budget, there's one thing I would like to bring up. We are, and we're not going to meet before this happens, so I wanted to ask the budget committee. The school board will be entering into negotiations with the union. And as you know, last year we didn't pass the collective bargaining agreement. And we have an issue with a number of teachers who are way off step there. In other words, they're not being paid what we as a community have agreed to a number of times in the contract, what they should be paid for their experience. And they're not being paid for that because we haven't passed collective bargaining agreement. And so I'm not going to talk about that this evening so much, but I would like to get sort of people's ideas. You can sort of talk among yourselves if you would like to about this, maybe just as a group. What kinds of things would you like to see, or what types of things can you support in a collective bargaining agreement? What would you like to see in a collective bargaining agreement that would be helpful just in terms of to help you support it? And I'll just throw out one that might be, for instance, just as individuals, what about a multi-year contract? One of the positive things about a multi-year contract is that you then know your expenses. They are known. You don't have to rethink it every year. You don't have to say, well, now we have to add this to the tax rate, because we already know this one. So that's one positive. So I heard three or four no's to be.
Mine's a no.
I'm a no.
I think that you have better bargaining power as a school board if you have a multi-year contract.
I think one of the things that I would like to see is a greater contribution from the teachers' central sector.
Well, last year, of course, and I'm going to say, they gave us a pretty hefty one.
What was that?
They gave us the biggest one they could. And I don't have the figures in front of me, but if they give back 1% in healthcare costs, it's a few $1,000s. It is not a lot of money. They are a small group of people. So last year they were giving back $45,000. It's unheard of. There is nothing. They would have to give us back like 20 or 30%.
Yeah. Under the Affordable Care Act, there's a limit below which the employer gives, I'm going to say, 9.35%. To the employee, otherwise it's considered unaffordable. And then if you have a large number of people in that group, then you start getting penalized under the.
I think you're talking about the Cadillac tax, isn't it?
No.
Well, we're not, anyway, I'm just saying, yes, it would be, and they did offer this back a lot. That's a great thing. So if you keep going, we're going to do that kind of thing. They were going to go to a cheaper plan. That's a big way to get back. And so that's good to hear. So
what percentage do they pay of the total premium now?
It depends on whether they're whether it's a single or two-person or a family. And so for the single, it's about, I think, again, I don't have it right in front of me. I think it's about 92% they would pay 8%, and for and I think it's the same percentage for the family of the one person in our contract. And I think it's about that they pay about, and again, I'm going to say 12%. Or 7.5%,
or 12% or 13%. Where do I keep stand as far as how the balance is standing? Because
yeah,
I know we were always pretty high, and I think that's the table.
Yeah, we're not as high anymore. It has we used to be. You're right. We used to be high in terms of our starting salary. We are not anymore. Other towns have crept up around us, and we have not.
But your salary is what's going to be your longevity as a teacher.
Yes, in terms of,
most of your long-term teachers have retired, and so your salaries are not as high anymore. I mean, based on the surrounding area as well. But that's why they were, that's why we would include that had a lot.
Actually, it's a good question, Dennis. There are two things to look at that. There is what do we actually pay out in salaries? And of course, the more experienced our teachers are, the more educated our teachers are. So if you get a teacher who's with 30 years experience, I mean, they're going to be pulling at a much higher salary than someone with 3 years experience. And so that's one. But the other thing to look at is what is our contracted salary? And it's in our, so what do we pay for a first year teacher with a master's degree compared to what does Marshall pay for a first year teacher with a master's degree? So that's another comparison that's probably a little cleaner to make. And those are becoming more even. What do we pay and what does Dover pay? What does someone we are a little bit higher. We have traditionally been a little bit higher than we and we no longer have a staff of 12 teachers who are at the highest level, which we did have for many, many years. And we no longer do. So our salaries have come down. And our salaries, I believe, are artificially down because not everyone's done them properly. Yeah.
I wouldn't mind seeing a multi-year contract. I'd like to see something that addresses the health care costs. I like what they did last year. I'd like to see something similar, work out the details. Philosophically, I don't mind paying good money for good teachers. What is the mechanism in place, or is there a mechanism, to remove someone who is not so good, shall we say? Do we have something in place? If we don't, can that be placed in the contract?
Yeah, that's obviously a concern for the school board as well. It's one of our charges. We don't want to be, we're a small school and one not so good teacher can really do a lot of damage. So we do, we certainly direct our administrators to keep a close eye on that.
So is there a mechanism in place?
Yes.
Okay.
Yes, there is.
I mean, if you want to offer something that might come into negotiations with us, I don't think we're very supposed to be doing that. Have you considered?
I'm just asking for a this is not binding in any way. I'm just
asking for things that might be helpful. Plan for benefits. You know, like that one for the car plan? In this school are part of the employer base for the SAU. They're not discrete.
They are a discrete union, just as in summer's work there is a discrete union for parents, a discrete union for teachers, and a discrete union for custodians. Okay. So, and they all have different insurance plans or can have different insurance plans. So I'm just saying that if it's by union,
but your contract, your costs are based on your union.
Yes.
Well, I'm just going to contradict what I just said. Because to the extent that, I mean, I think it's worth exploring, because to the extent that trying to do an advocacy plan, it's usually more helpful for the employee because they can figure out where they need, you know, they need more life insurance, or, you know, they're a spouse, they get a medical year. So it does provide some flexibility and makes it easier sometimes to have an overall reduction in the benefit cost. But those of your employee base, you know, we can be happy. I wonder about the smallness of it, that's all. That was my concern. But it's worth it for.
And it also has to be something that we can get into the right cost.
Yeah.
Okay. Yeah, good idea.
A buyout? A buyout.
insurance buyout,
yeah.
We offer insurance buyout.
But you own the library for what? How do you offer that?
We offer.
Going
out with so many. Well, we would allow everyone to buy out of our insurance if they
wanted
to. So often what happens is if you choose not to take our insurance, we will pay you not to take it.
Well, that's how it's very funny.
Right, well, that is an offer that we have. It's in the contract. Yeah. Well, it has been for as long as I've been working at the contract.
We
only have one. Yeah, I mean, we have a small group of people who qualify for our insurance plan, and and it's even smaller because not all of these people are insurance. That's a tough one, but it's one of the things we keep working on.
I have a real quick when you say multi-year contract, you thought you 2 or 3 years.
I like an ARC on a 3 year. We actually proposed one 3 years ago, and it was supported by the budget committee. I was looking back at that. It did not pass. It fell into the year when nothing passed for the school. And that had nice ARC to it, and it was a nice one. It allows flexibility, as Denise was saying. The multi-year allows flexibility, and then it's a known commodity for the length of the contract.
I think 3 years, the other residents are wrong for it. Months of the study, which do. I just think they look at the big picture, because you have to present the big picture of the contract, so you have to present what the anticipation on the bottom line would be. It's going to be a big number, because you have to tell them that it's going to be 3 years.
But maybe 2 years.
Mm-hmm. Absolutely.
I think that what scared them was we had a 3 year contract at one time and it was exorbitant and the bottom fell out of everything and that they were still giving 5% because we went into a 3 year 5-5-5. That was a while ago.
That's what I remember. Mm-hmm.
And then everything fell, but we still were at the 5-5-5, but nobody else was getting the 5 that was working in the work.
Yeah,
probably because of the capital improvements at the grade school is why it was high, and now we don't have as many capital improvements, so that's why it dropped.
More on articles
to repair the school.
It passed asbestos removal and floor replacement, replace power.
Yes, and you're right, and I included those when I did my look at the total budget, of course, because it's all part of it. It's a whole package, right? Operating budget, warrant articles, and collective bargaining agreement. And so that actually increases the amount that it belongs for grade school as part of.
Right.
And those are included in the years I've looked at.
Sorry, but that was the confusion reduction last year, is that right? So, under the
collective bargaining, they were a one-year contract that got voted down. Do they sign a contract for 3 years when they get hired and expect those steps every time? And then you come to the town and say, this is what they're asking for collective bargaining, but they've already signed a contract saying that they're going to get it?
In the state of New Hampshire, it is not uniform. There are individual contracts with individual unions. There are many school districts, some of them around us, that give the step increase even if the collective bargaining agreement fails. We are one of the districts that does not do that. We do not do it even if the collective bargaining agreement fails. To Suzanne's point, teachers are not lawyers. Teachers say, oh, yes, well, this is reasonable. This is a reasonable step increase. I'm getting more insurance. I'm getting more education. I'm getting more experience. This is reasonable. And this is what I expect. I mean, certainly, I know back when I signed a teacher's contract, it's great. I'm going to go up a bit each year. That's great for my experience. I didn't stop to think of it if there hadn't been a contract. It's a difficult situation, and these younger, newer teachers are saving us money every single year they teach here. We want to be able to attract these kinds of people, young people with lots of enthusiasm and energy and good teachers. And we'll talk more about that when I have more stuff to talk about after the break. But we have to find a way to get them on their proper steps. And if people have ideas, I really would like to hear them. We really have to find a way as a town to do it. It's a serious liability for a great school. We're not going to be able to attack the best and the brightest. Okay.
Well, again, I think we have to present that in a contract to the town. That's the only way to get it done. It's a collective bargaining agreement with this group. And that's my concern, is that are we going outside that? Now, I don't know what the contract says specifically, but to address those issues that are contractual issues, I think the only way to do it is a new contract.
Yes, and that's why I'm asking tonight, what is this collective group who says they recommend or don't recommend a collective bargaining agreement? What would you recommend if we could get, you know, what kinds of things would help you recommend that if it comes back, that you get all the teachers on the right step?
You want to hand it to me?
Sure.
A much bigger cut in the school budget. I would be willing to bet, politically, that it's not the cut. And what I'm saying is people would be more likely to be, okay, let's talk this much of a reduction in the school, which is so many dollars on the tax bill, and they would like
The problem is, we could cut $200,000 from, let's say $100,000 from the RGS school bill. However, Marshwood is going up. And therefore, there's no overall school district savings. So it's very so we're asking our teachers not to get paid while Marshall is receiving 1.5% and 2.5%. That's what they've been receiving in the 3 years, not in this year, that we're attending there. We are paying for Marshall teacher increases in salary.
I wouldn't do that. Significant reduction in the RGS budget would go a long way for making a bargaining agreement specific. That's my sense of the community.
But you lost your money in your budget and not get your contract as well.
Right.
But if there are
ways to save so that we can say, look, we saved this much. And again, if we combine everything with warrants, and for instance, if we don't have warrants this year, I mean, there's a savings right there, right? If we don't have a lot of extra warrants. And if the only one is the collective bargaining agreement. That might help.
Can you just explain how the bonuses work for the across community? Yeah. Five teachers receive bonuses for their extraordinary work and for saving us money over the last 6 years.
Were those teachers who did not get second track or were off second track?
No teachers are off track. They are off track.
So those five teachers were off track.
Right.
And is that the only type of people, the people that were off track?
Yes.
And it was so that with a 15,000 rule, it was restricted across 5 years?
That's correct. Not employees, right there. The middle school, most middle schools in the state are 6, 7, and 8. It was in Summersworth, and it is in Marshall, correct. We have not yet pursued that because it actually would not be cost effective at the moment. But we have not, our pushback of the envelope, it's not cost effective. But we have not pursued that yet.
But you are.
It's there in the back of our mind. We renegotiate the contract in another year, so that's the only problem.
Oh, okay.
So that would
be next.
I have to circle back to a prior conversation about last year that we got an extra June 30th thing, and I had a break here on the 20th. Would you like to send you a copy?
No, it was last year. Thanks.
No, what I'm saying is, it was able to be produced last year. And I'm wondering why you can't do it again this year. You did it last year. There it is.
Yeah, well, I didn't, and what you saw was something the school board did not see, so it had to have been, like, marked unofficial, draft. I don't know. I have no idea.
Yeah, it's a draft, but it was a technical flaw.
Okay. I mean,
Okay, now a step increase, is that 5%?
Mm-hmm. It depends on the step you're on, but yeah, it's about 2,000. It works out, actually, I did the math on an average, but it's just under $2,000 a year, yes.
It's 5% one way and 5% it's 5% each.
They've done the math.
Yeah. I think 5% is pretty high just for a step, not including the rates. And I'd like to see the teachers pay more than what they do for a percentage. That's what I would like for their health insurance. That's my thoughts.
If not everyone gets a step in the top.
I know that.
Oh, okay. So when you're saying want all of the teachers to contribute to their health care, you're saying teachers aren't getting what the others are. So
I don't know. What is it companies around here pay for life insurance? Maybe 40?
You mean health insurance?
Yeah, for health insurance. Do they pay 90%?
Yeah.
Or less. Yeah. We should do this time.
Yeah, I appreciate it. Thank you very much. Thank you very much, Aya. So now we'll go on to questions on the budget. Y'all start asking your questions.
Just one question. From this, what is essentially April data, you had 77,114. How much of that is spent?
That? How much is that? Zero.
In other words, that 77,000 is coming back.
As far as we know at the moment, yes.
Where are you?
There's a summary page on the front.
As Denise was saying, we don't know until all the accounts close, obviously.
Well, last year there were things that we sort of capitalized. Here's the storage shed.
We do have capital items. Those are already encumbered and out of this number.
Okay. Last year there was paving and there was other structural things, and suddenly when we got to the end of the year, that balance is at zero. Right?
Yeah, but we have already encumbered some of those items. We've encumbered the shed, windows in the annex, and bathroom repair.
Okay, so that's 77,000.
That's 77,000 is two. As of that time.
Well, I want to know, is it June 30th?
What do you know?
This is what I know. This is the only budget I have reviewed. I just put a period on that, remember?
In 8 days, you'll find out.
Yes, we'll have another one.
I've got a quick question on, okay, so the maintenance of the ground. You spent $150,700.
Can you show me what page?
2630 is the
2630.
Jack, can you tell me that page?
The first page.
First page.
Oh, okay. On the summary?
Oh, maintenance of ground.
Yeah. Would you give me a breakdown of what you...
Yeah, those are the board approved projects.
Yeah, I know
those are the shed,
yep.
The bathroom repair, and I did not bring that list with me. So
October's fine. What I'd just like to do is have a breakdown of that, and then a follow-up on that is where that money came from, what accounts. Okay?
What accounts? It's on the
floor. Well, if you have $150,000.
Yes. I can tell you that. As we discussed last time, we had an overage based on the way special ed was being. Now, an update on that is it's still being worked on. Our business people and Marshall's business people and our special ed people and their special ed people are sitting down and they are still working this out. So we're not done with that.
It's a work in progress.
It's definitely a work in progress.
And it can change overnight.
Well, we just need to work out that we're talking the same language. That's all they care about at this moment, so that we can budget properly for it. But yes, the $150,000, I mean, I'm practically notified, but
well, you can just send it in October. That's fine. Huh? Just a general breakdown.
Okay. Yep.
No problem. I think I know what most of them
are. Any other comments on, do you want to go page by page there, or something?
Can you comment about the custodial overage? I mean, it's the same thing. In this budget, which is for the year just finished, we had budgeted for 2 half-time custodians. It worked out that we could keep 1 full-time, someone who really knew the school, who was an excellent employee. We were really glad that we could keep him. And then to fill in the time when we actually need 2 people on site, we would do an hourly person.
So the full-time person is an benefit?
Yes, benefits and everything.
It's just still paper.
Not formally, no.
No, so he gets whatever.
Yeah, he got 2%. He's got 2% in the budget that was approved in March.
No.
Okay. Nothing that affects the job.
You have any idea of the potential changes in population for middle school and high school markets? Is there going to be adding more students?
Well, adding more students is interesting. We are going up. We're going up at Marshwood because of even Summersworth, of course. This is our last year. This fiscal year of 2018 is our last year in Summersworth. We have some bubbles moving through middle school at the moment. So the budget we're going to start working on, we're going to have more students in Marshwood than we currently have in middle and high school. Because we have more students moving into the grades.
New
people moving in. I don't, as you may recall, for the budget we're in right now, we have 3 contingency students built in. That was partly due to your recommendation. We have to recommend for the number that we would do that with. So, I don't know. And the thing is, we don't know. We don't know until we get enrollment. I mean, we won't know until,
they're up to show up.
Yeah,
we
started in a schedule now. There are
Meeting on the holidays.
Does anybody remember why we didn't do the 13th stuff?
We did the 18th for the 5th. When I got on here, did that change?
So if that was last year, then that would really come back a week.
Does anybody have any objections to that?
I just have it so cool. The suggestion is when we meet at 29 for something, I'm just looking at that, we meet at 6 for something, 29th of November, 6th of December, yeah. And now we had nothing in the 13th, the suggestion is the school on the 13th, mm-hmm. Yeah. And that's so the town can now occupy the 20th.
Right.
That was our way into
the Yeah, I'm using what all of us are going to go on. I would love that.
There was a little bars and the little ones where I went by. You don't know how many dollars where they go. Some of these people are very confused. So we're moving to the league. Anybody have any problems with that? Come to one of them. That's where we're going. I've got three rooms. All right?
Well, I would just say, I mean, I can see your advantages and disadvantages. So the parking and access, where is that?
The chairs are small custom.
It's a presentation. It's really to forget. And of course, we're not always available.
It's not a Saturday meeting.
Right.
And the school, our time in school, the school was marking up their meetings after school. It's a chance for people to come into the school they never have, who often don't get in, so it's a way for us to help them in the school.
I believe that the April meeting, there was a discussion that somebody, I don't remember who it was supposed to check in and see if we could get a meeting to go to.
For what, Jim?
For the school delivery. On the 13th of January, and then the second school one on February 3rd.
And the school is saying they prefer to have that at the school.
It's nice to be able to show off the school a little bit, the town meeting on 317.
I'll probably spend 10-15 minutes on the final budget of the school and we'll get it. Since we didn't really get a final budget.
I want to say no.